users accept the treats, the terms and services? And how does instructor find struggles when they are doing tasks? And finally, the last example is how the participants pay attention during meeting, presentation, and conference. You can just sleep during an online conference. Even the government officials sleep during their meeting. And what happens if it's online? And so let's ask another question. Can the conventional web logs, educational data only, monitor complicated discombobulated online activities? The answer that, in my opinion, is it cannot, because the conventional log can only tell who is in the system and what it is about and when it is. It cannot tell how they interact with the web contents, for example, how do they read and which part they read the most. This is just a simple example. But I noticed there are some human interface that can generate these deeper logs, and those are mind tracking and mouse tracking. I will explain further about mouse tracking in the later section. Even though I agree that mind tracking is the best among these three, but why it cannot be widely implemented today? That is because eye tracking is inconvenient. One is intrusive, as you can see in the previous slide. You need to wear a goggle. Even though they are those that are very advanced eye tracking, where it is not intrusive, it can be very expensive, up to $10,000. Yes, up to $10,000, and maybe even more. While mouse tracking is inconvenient, where you do need to have an additional hardware. In default, available in every computer, just computer, and that's enough, and it is non-intrusive because usually users are not aware that they are being mouse tracked. The second problem is about what it is about the mouse tracking. Even though that we choose mouse tracking, the previous application in many research articles, they are mostly only for offline and in laboratories. They are rarely used for implementation. So they must be installed on each client, for example, she takes to the desktop, and the data are stored in each client and must be retrieved individually. So the solution that we provided on this thesis is an online mouse tracking. They can be implemented as a client application. The data are sent on the server, but it must be installed in each client. Or you can just choose a server application where there is no additional installation, only on the server, and the data are sent on the server as well. But even after we decided to implement mouse tracking widely, there is a rumor that the mouse tracking generates big data. Even if you're Google or a very powerful big data company, you might not have a problem, but if you are a university in a developed, especially in developing region, you will have a problem with the big data generated. So these are the five things that that defines big data. But the most problematic of all is the volume, which is the size of the mouse tracking data, and the velocity. And also the veracity as well, because it's the transmission can be due to loss of limited connectivity. Although there are many other types, but this one is for data analytics, where the main problem for us to tackle is the history. And by having the problem, we have the objective of this thesis, which is to write an application that can capture mouse tracking and other browser human interface called mouse tracking. Make the mouse tracking application online that can be implemented in public. Investigate its data generation and resource usage, and reduce its data generation and resource usage. And the other, and the last objective is that we will dig deeper into mine deeper than other conventional logs, such as online analytics and conventional educational data, where in the content perspective point of view, the conventional log and education data can mine only up to the page or the content of the area. While in mouse tracking, we aspect of what is happening in the areas and the coordinates of the content. Now in chapter 2 is to explain the new online mouse tracking or the mouse tracking system overview and implementation. So to start off, so this is our mouse tracking. So mouse tracking is the recording, is basically the recording of clicks, movements, scrolls, zooms, keylogs, copies, and other events, but mainly these three, click, movement, and scrolls, and the other can be added. And in the mobile, the mouse is replaced with a touch tracking. So it's not a mouse, but a touch, which can identify the position where the touch and other interactions. This is the system that we built. So on the right side is the server, on the left side is the client. If it's a server mouse tracking implementation, the mouse tracking code is inserted into the JavaScript section of the website or the web page, which contain HTML and CSS. If it's a client implementation, then it's not on the JavaScript, but directly on the client. So the process goes that the client opens a web page, and that web page contains HTML and CSS, view the web page, and the JavaScript with the mouse tracking code is running on the background process. And what indicates this one as an online mouse tracking is the data that is sent to the server, not stored on the client, and can be stored on a file or a database. So because mouse tracking tracks personal information, the United States, the European Union, and most other countries must follow some privacy policy in the public domain. It is mandatory that we disclose what data that is tracked. For example, if you have visit web pages, you can see that pop-up of cookies. You set to record these cookies and stuff, so it's actually the same, no different with mouse tracking. For example, it shows the allow mouse click, mouse move, and etc. But over there, in important events such as school exams or other important activities, so you can just make an agreement with the student, for example, an exam, that we need to track their activities, because we need to prevent some dishonest behavior. But if they do not agree, then you can just deny them of following the exam. So you can make an agreement, something like that. And then we make an implementation. So this is, for example, a client application of mouse tracking, which is a browser extension installed on Chromium. So the client requirement is the hardware, anything to do, even a Raspberry Pi 3 works. It just needs a browser that supports JavaScript. And the log storage supports both online, and a file or database storage. For a server application, this is an example that we made. We installed the mouse tracking as a theme plugin or block plugin in our laboratory Moodle site. And we also made this Moodle plugin easy to install. All that is needed is to download the zip, compare and upload to the Moodle, and then configure essential events together and use page to track and activate tracking for whole website. If not, just put the JavaScript code into the any website that any administrator should know what to do. For the server specification, we cannot identify how powerful the server should be, because it depends on the number of users. But for our lab server, this is the specification. But for the software side, it just needs a web server, which is Apache 2, any web server will do. PHP is only for the storage, or any other language also do. And the database can be MySQL or MariaDB. The advantage is that the client needs no additional application except running operating system. So it's no need to install anything. Just visit the webpage and then master inbound, so no additional stuff. But the disadvantage of the server is that we cannot track outside of the website. We can only track inside, but we can know that if they go outside, we can say that the users went out to the webpage. We can only know that they go out and go in. But if you want to make to record every detail of the user, it must be installed on the client side. And then we do an experiment, which is a mastering session between students in Mongolia and Japan. So it was conducted on January 3rd, 2019. It is a midterm exam of microprocessor interface in the mid-course for sophomore and junior students. There are 15 multiple choices questions. The duration is around 1 hour each. It was running from 13 to 15:30. And there are 21 clients, and this is their department, which they assess the quiz that is on Japan. So this experiment is to prove that the mastering can be run widely and globally. But then there is a big data problem rumor, so we investigate and we obtain a mouse tracking data. This is just the raw file in form of a table. So there is the date, the x and y, where the mouse position, whether they went in or went out of the page, and there is that click and duration as well. And this is the proof that we found that mouse tracking generates a huge amount of data. Because the daily page view is only for, that is for 2 months, only 13 kilobyte. Other Moodle log is only about less than 5 megabyte. Now for mouse tracking, only for 3 hours, it generates 100 megabyte for around 40 students. Even though there are other ones, but as you can see that mouse tracking generates a huge data, which can be a problem. And for further proof, this is another data that we obtained, that the how much students generate during a mouse tracking session in a Mongolian quiz session. So there are students, which this one may be not so well students, maybe they just they cheat and stuff, generate a small amount, but roughly in average they generate 40 megabyte or 10,000 queries in its sessions, and the maximum that we found is that they can generate up to 90 to 200,000 megabytes in the session. So now we know that the huge data is true. So in chapter 3, it's to define how to reduce this cost or how to perform a saving method, resource saving methods. The existing solution is in the data is to reduce the redundant data, such as, for example, shorten the URL, decrease the sampling sampling rate, for example, capture only maximum of 20 events per second, or it's the same as delay the capture for interval of 50 milliseconds. And an adaptive sampling, which is do not capture any, do not track when the user is idle. And some compression methods, which is done by other colleagues from other parts of the world, so but not in this thesis. And in this thesis, we have that we should do the mouse tracking in real time, not that, which is because what happens if we do not do it in real time, as we see in the previous data. If it's like this, then the network can be a bottleneck. But if we do it in the real time, which is we send the events immediately on occurrence, whenever the data is generated, send it immediately, not wait, then it can distribute the burdens over the time domain. And the novel method that we introduced in this thesis is the lossy based on demand coordinate compression. So it's basically about is summarizing the mouse tracking coordinates into areas. So we define there is three, a Basically, the 2-1, the default is a full nail striking without compression. The highest compression is the most summerates into one area, which is one area at the maximum. While the region of interest nail striking, we can divide them into many regions. So you can divide them into many areas depending on the administrator. So how does that impact the transmission? Data transmission of mouse tracking. If we do it like this, so then whenever the mouse moves into small areas, the data is sent, which is why involved mouse tracking generates a high amount of data. But if we summarize the data into the mouse tracking into area, so the data is summarized first, then it is sent. So the amount of care will be less. This is why that the summarizing into area can reduce the transmission and storage costs. And the next one is the highest compression, which is to summarize them into one area, one whole big area. So once the session ends, so only then that the data is sent. So also the in theory it is only one query per area daily. And then we simulate the 3 mouse tracking into this client and single board into, since we do not have a second experiment, we do not have the opportunity, so we regret that we can only do a simulation of the 3 mouse tracking and but we have the data, so we can make an accurate simulation. So this is, for example, how much storage is reduced for the default mouse tracking. There is 286 queries, around data size is 100. So because there is some data problem, we can only use half of the data. So it is this much. And for the region of interest, actually, we can do many, break them into many data. Sorry, I forgot to say how much area this is, but the region of mouse interest, trial mouse tracking one, this contains 50 areas, so the mouse tracking log is summarized into 50 areas. The second one is summarized into 35 areas, and the third one is summarized into 20 areas. So the more you summarize, the more the data is reduced. And until the maximum summarized where the coordinates are summarized into one area. So we can reduce up to this much. And for the transmission, it also impacts the thing. So it reduced up to over 50% of the storage and transmission. So, and the CPU as well, and also for the RAM usage. So it impacts the storage in both the transmission boxes. Now in chapter 4 is to answer about the problems in the user interface and how to capture users and why we need to capture them. So as I explained before, that we mine deeper into this area. So how to monitor and follow the online activities and while mouse tracking can. Now we go to the webpage of the course on just have a look. So here it is shown that for the address for problem one, potential cheating, the mouse tracking can identify how many times the users or the students are leaving the page. So for example, that this shows that students frequently leave the page to, for example, to Google or somewhere. So we know that the student can be cheating or they can be asking for questions and so ever. And because that was an unintentional data that we found. So in the future, we can make a possible software called online examination leak detector. So for example, if the students leave the page, then they will be disqualified. If the mouse leaves the page, if they press Alt tab, or if they press a Windows or Meta button, or anything that indicates them leaving the page, they will be disqualified, or maybe at the very least they will be warned not to leave the page for examination. So this is one possible software. we are able to create a heat map. So this shows that which area of the quiz they are most they spend most of the time on. For example, on this one, they spend most of the time on question 3, but they don't spend so much on question 4 and question 2. So this is some example visual analysis that we can use to analyze how to replace face-to-face monitoring to online monitoring. And this is the more detail of the heat map. And for this one, they spend more time on this quiz session, and the one interesting part that I found is that on quiz 15, they don't spend much time. Maybe they are already tired and they want to just finish. But based on the grade, almost every student have this quiz wrong. So why do they spend less time? Maybe they give up or whatever. And with that, we are able to make a feature work for a possible software, which is a term observer's leading detector. For example, if the user reads this one, if the user reads 2 and 3, but they did not read passage 3, and they click agree, then they will ask the So this is a read detector. So if they haven't finished reading, so the system will ask them to finish reading. If they finish reading, they can proceed. So it is very good for thermal services and to monitor stuff. And then here we have another sample visual analysis, which is for inevitable log, where we can visualize up to the points of the contents. So the interesting part here is this one, the right click and the highlighting of that, which is to show that they are highlighting the triangle is the left click, the middle click is the square, and the center one is the right click. So they perform many left click, which is highlight. So they can be, and then they perform a right click, which indicates copying of text. And then in the log data, they leave the page. Maybe they are searching for Google or searching for answers on outside. And here are some other not so interesting data, but this one is to show that they are choosing questions, and the square one is to show that they are performing scrolling up and down. So to conclude this presentation, we are able to address the three problems that is for online monitoring, especially during this coronavirus. So we've made with this problem one regarding to the monitoring demand for human online interaction. We can make a bit detector for a cheating detection and stuff for online exam. And for problem two, which is about mouse tracking for wide implementation and for public usage, that we make the software and we experimented between two countries and it worked. And then we address some novel solutions for how to reduce the data over 50% of the default mouse tracking summarized areas. And I would like to return the time to
thank you very much. So now it's open for the discussion of the of course the delegates, all of you are very welcome to the raise your hand and put the question on. No question?
You used the Moodle.
Yes.
So how about another kind of system? I'm not sure that there will be a kind of system.
Yes. It works on, for the mouse tracking, it can work on every website, including Moodle, including
primary impact water system?
Yes.
But it is applicable to another system?
Yes. So there is a one main source code that is applicable to all system. So we just have one main source code that is in JavaScript, and then we need to convert the main source code into Moodle plugin or other plugin. But we have one main source code which can be implemented to others. So this one is just example that we make it into Moodle plugin.
Yeah, another question.
Yes.
You divided that some part of the display, the region.
Yes.
So that how do you divide? How many areas?
How do I divide? So the division in technical is the area. So for example, the size of this page is defined by pixels. So from left is 0, and here is 1,980 pixels, and to bottom is to up to undefined. So we divide in technical point. We divide the area for example, what is the left limit, what is the right limit, what is the upper limit, and what is the bottom limit. So we divide them into a square. And your question is, for as a user, how to divide? One is manually. So we define. So we have to define where is question one, question two, question three. It is very exhausting labor. Or the second one is we do it automatically, but very limited. It depends on the structure of the website. If the website or Moodle have a good structure, we can divide them into good areas. If it doesn't have a good structure, then it will be divided into some bad areas. Otherwise, we have to do it manually. And for the future work, we cannot do automatic or smart area definition, because for smart area decision, it needs to be done by a human. So we need a computer as smart as a human to do that. So we need to do, in the future work, we need to do some machine learning to find good areas.
So anyway, you can easily select, you can easily change at the end.
Yes, change, but tiring.
How about the model for the National University of Mongolia examination case? You did by yourself,
myself.
By hand?
Yes, by hand. So, yes. So, okay. So, if you will open my dissertation here. And I can show you that I divided manually by myself. And it took me like a whole day. So for example, like this one. So I divided into many areas, so let me enlarge. So this one. So for example, there is the header. I need to find the left, the right, the up and the bottom. And I need to do the same for all the things. So it took me like a whole day. So that is why it is tiring for myself.
But as you mentioned, Moodle knows the quiz, if you're focusing only there,
yes.
Maybe the related structures, the possibility you will design for the availability you will scaling.
Yes, the scaling.
Probably it's a future work, but yeah.
Yes.
It's a very much specific for the application though.
Yes, that's right, but when the scaling is different, Moodle you have to adjust, but if you use another system, you need to change the algorithm,
yeah,
because they have
one by one, of course. And further question. I have the maybe 5-10 minutes. Any of the Zoom member, they has the question. No. Okay.
looks closely perfect. I mean, that's very, very good probably. I believe that you observed many problems arise in the development of the system. You have given reasonable solutions to each of the problems that you did. But there are something I didn't get very well. For example, can you show at 46 or 45 of your presentation? Before that, 45, please. Yes, this one. And here, we see that on this website, we have, for example, three or more questions here. And to answer to each of the questions, of course, we need to put something on each of the areas. That means that we do not need to record all of the months in the movement report. So I'm not so sure. Can you tell us briefly what are the really good data that your system can allow us to record, and what your system can allow us to analyze for getting the behaviors of the users?
Okay. That is a tough question, but I will try. So the good data, there is three simple data. So this one is like a long, and then is how many clicks and movements, and the combination of these three data. So we need to, so in my opinion, we need to do a human experiment. For example, like we need one group of students that is given a difficult quiz, one student given an easy quiz. So for example, the one given a difficult one, they are stressed. So we need to capture their mouse tracking and the mouse tracking of the two of them. And then we compare. So we will have a label that this is mouse tracking data most likely who are students that are stressed. This one is most likely who are not stressed. And then we need to do which one who are cheating. For example, we allow them to cheat and the other one don't allow to cheat. So we need to divide them into many activities. And then we can generate a database. For example, like a office-based presentation, we can make a ground truth that this kind of mouse tracking or movements of links, this kind of activities is labeled as stress, cheating, not cheating, so something like that. But for now, those kind of data is not as good as the current data, so no one has performed label and something, so it's a good opportunity to make together data.
I see. And another one is that if apart from e-learning data analysis,
yes,
what kind of applications do you think this system can really work very well? Very well means that this one enables us to have many valuable data.
Okay. So other than data analysis, this one is actually good for disabled users. So it's actually research that I plan to do, but I made the program already, but it's very hard to complete because many factors like just getting the data and stuff. For example, if we use a mouse movement, this is small, for example, right? So for those who are not able to read or elder people, if the mouse points to this text, maybe it can automatically enlarge to the optimal size. So something like that.
Mm.
Or maybe the mouse, when it's moved, it changes the color for colorblind people. Kind of colorblind, but Yeah, some part of the register, something like that.
That's interesting, yeah.
Well, time is coming up. Any question or comments? Yes, thank you.
Thank you very much for your presentation. So I think the difficulty is discrepancy between the mouse movement and the user's behavior.
Yes.
So do you think it's possible to almost of the behavior of the users? I think users usually grab the mouse pointer in your system, but some users do not grab the mouse pointer and thinking using a pencil or so.
So that is one of the problems. For example, if you want to measure attention, mouse it may not be a good solution. Because, for example, like when I read text, I don't use the mouse, I put the mouse outside. But maybe we can use the scroll, that is one. But according to your, but based on your answer, your questions, there is already ongoing research that is correlation between mouse eye and other tracking. So when they are doing an eye tracking, they are also analyze the movement, and they, based on the mouse movement, they try to correlate to the eye. So maybe if the mouse is doing this kind of movement, maybe the eye is somewhere here, so something like that. So there is already competitive research in that area. I did not go in because it's already very competitive.